feeling like Ty. Watch what she doing, they like shy. Drunk niggas try.
Hey y'all, so let me first show y'all what time it is right now. Look at the time. It's currently 1:42 in the morning and I have work at 9, but I really wanted to do this video. I have my hot chocolate here and I just wanted to do this video because as the year is ending off, I know we still have a couple more days of 2020, but I felt like it was really important to do this video just to kind of reflect on everything that's went on with me, went on in the world, went on with y'all, if y'all want to share that too in the comment section. But I think it was just like, it's been a crazy year for like a lot of people, and I think it's important for us to just like really unpack that instead of just holding it and bringing it to the next year. So I guess the way I want to start it off is kind of just talking about like sections of the year or like each month or something like that, and then also ending off with ways that I've been helping improve my mental health. So let's start with like January, February. That like end of January was just so crazy with like Kobe and Gianna passing in that manner. It was like, how could this happen? Like, why? And the thing that really stuck with me is the fact that the day before he passed, like the accident happened, he literally was just like congratulating LeBron for breaking his record. And I thought that was like, it's crazy. It's a crazy way to the last memory of that person, you know. So yeah, that was just really crazy. Another one that just really stuck out to me was the Pop Smoke thing. I felt like he had so much to gain in life. He had so much to achieve in life, and it was just too early. And the way that it happened is just like, I just keep thinking, even though I didn't know him personally, just like the way I saw like his interviews and stuff, the vibe he had.
You can get it.
Lower your tone.
Is it hold on?
Hold on.
Lower your tone.
You think I'm aggressive?
No.
Bow!
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 This is aggressive.
Wait.
Yes!
I think I'm something's wrong with me.
So baby, welcome to the party. I'm a thot. Give me lit. That got nothing to do with no girls. It could. But that's some street shit. That just mean I'm with whatever.
I really think he would have been like a really cool person. Like, I could really see myself like being friends with him. But it was I just kept thinking like, what if this happened? What if that happened? You know? And the thing that they said too that just really stuck out to me was the fact that that was the one night he wasn't in the studio. Like, he's been in the studio back to back promoting his album that just released like 2-3 weeks prior. And that happened, and it was just like, why? You know, barely 20, like a baby, like it's sad. And I just felt bad for his family. Like, he was very family orientated, and just to lose him like that, it was really heartbreaking for me because it was just so many layers to it. I'm a fan, and he was definitely bringing a different wave in the music industry. And he was bringing that new wave of like the UK drill, because I was already listening to UK music. Like, I've just always just been listening to UK music. I kind of just kind of moved away from like US music because I feel like everyone's talking about the same thing, but I know that's like their life that they live. But that's actually how I got onto Pop Smoke, because I had like seen like stuff, but I never listened to like his music, like Welcome to Party. I never listened to it until it showed up on like my daily mix for Spotify. So just like with that, it was just sad. It was really sad that his family had to go through that, and he was so young. I feel like he has so much to live for, so much, and it was just this whole all around just really sad situation. It seemed like he had a really big heart, and that was another thing too. He had a heart murmur too, so it was like really, I don't know, it was just really sad the way that everything went down. I guess after that, what happened? Corona. that one. It's just, it's still, we're still dealing with that right now. I know they're doing a vaccine, but still. That has been a travesty for like people all over. People are passing. We're currently in lockdown. But that's the thing, like, about me. I'm trying not to, like, talk about me right away because I want to go through the year first. But the thing with me, I actually like being indoors. But, like, to this point, I think as human beings, regardless of how much you like to be in your room or in your own space, you still need that human interaction. And with COVID, we're not getting that. We're kind of just not, we're being taken away from that. So it's been really hard. It's been so sad, the number of people that have passed away because of the pressure of being at home and having that isolation, having that human interaction. It takes a major toll on us as human beings. So it's just sad to just see like weekly or monthly of someone passing away because they can't deal with it. They can't handle the fact that this is going on. And it's understandable because we are not meant to be isolated as human beings. We are supposed to have that human interaction. We're supposed to interact with one another. And it's sad to just see like people in like elementary and middle school and just in those really, really young ages feeling that amount of sadness and depression or what's going on with them, especially with the people having like school as like their escape from their home life, never knowing like what's going on at home. I know like a major thing that they have brought up in like statistic domestic abuse at home have went up because these people that faced that weren't able to leave their house and escape from that situation they were in. They were stuck at home. So I thought that was just like something really crazy. I guess just to fast forward to George Floyd. That was really major for me just because it happened in the state that I'm from. And
nigga house like the Tomb Raider.
A lot of people when they hear Minnesota, they're like, oh, what's going on there? Like, a major thing I would always hear was like, oh, do black people even live there? And like, yeah, like, yes, we are here. And that was just, it was really crazy because it was very close to home. Like when police brutality happens in the nation, it does like have an impact on me because I am black, but it's just like, okay, this is at the distance. I'm still like advocating for this cause. I'm still advocating on my social media, but it's not happening close. My bad, y'all. My camera turned off. But yeah, with that, I always feel like I'm very naive with that because my mindset is, oh, this is not happening where I'm at, so I'm safe. Which is a horrible mindset because when the George Floyd murder happened, it was definitely a slap in the face of a wake-up call because it's like, this whole time I've always had that mindset of, oh, that, no, that can't happen where I'm from, that won't happen where I'm from. Not saying that like, oh, it's all peaches and cream and lollipops and Willy Wonka's world, excuse me, but you know, we definitely have our share of stuff. You know, Philando Castillo happened some years back, so I don't know why it was so much of a shock as it was with George Floyd. But I know another thing too, like with the African community, it's so hard to explain to the older generations about like police brutality and all that stuff because they often try to like blame the black people, which is really hard to, this is not saying like all Africans are like this because I'm African myself, so it's not like, oh, I'm out here blaming, no, it's just like it's hard to describe the mindset that a lot of these older generations have because they don't fully understand the extent of systematic racism. So that was just something else that really, that took a major toll. But I think the one that really impacted me, just like on that same level, be Breonna Taylor. That was major for me as a black woman. I had major trouble sleeping. I think I, and you're probably like, oh, are you having trouble sleeping now? Because, you know, it's like almost 2 a.m. But no, I was actually doing over 90 Christmas cards from work that I have. So that's why I have, that's why I'm up right now. I literally just finished it. But with Breonna Taylor, I had a major hard time sleeping. I think I went to sleep at 4 a.m. For 2 months, I believe, because then I came back to school. But yeah, I had a really hard time sleeping. And especially since like the area that I live in now, that's not diverse as much as like where I'm originally from. I just always had like that feeling of like, oh my gosh, what that happens to me, you know? And it's just like, it's an eerie feeling of I'm not safe. And and before it was like, even I didn't feel safe before, but at this point it was like, okay, if someone can go into this woman's house that she pays rent and she's sleeping on her one day off, what about me that's in school? That's what I'm doing. I'm just in school. I'm working for the school, so it's still just like school itself. What if that happens to me? And that's what I really was concerned about, because I didn't feel protected. So I always had like that eerie feeling, and that really pushed me to like really advocate even more. And it's just disheartening how much she did not get justice, and still people are fighting for her. But it just really shows like how disrespected black women are, how unprotected black women are, how neglected black women are, all things that Malcolm X said. And that was just major for me. Like, it was crazy. I guess just to fast forward again, me getting like hit by a car, to be honest with y'all, I've been bumped by a car, like, because, and every time it's always the driver's fault. Because the first time it happened, I was going to cross the street, because it had like the walk sign up, and the lady only looked her left, but she didn't look her right where we were walking, and she just like bumped me with her car. But it was the fact that this guy pushed me with his car and was laughing. And then for me to be told by a dispatcher, oh, I shouldn't be rude. Have you really lost your mind to the point that you're not understanding the fact I just got hit by a car, and he wasn't going to stop. Like, he was going to run me over. He was going to kill me right then and there. And that's the part that really just pisses me off, because then the officers over here talking about, did I get hit or did I get bumped? Does it matter? Someone put a vehicle and tried to hit me with their vehicle. So that was just, and even with that, it really bothered me, because it's like the whole thing with Breonna Taylor just happened. And then for this to happen, it's like, you know, I would have just been another hashtag and that would have been it. So yeah, that was major for me as well. I guess also like the presidential race was major. I know another thing, like, that was a concern for me too, since I am like in a smaller town and a lot of these people are I'm in a red area. It was just kind of concerning to me too, like, just even going outside, because it's like, I already got hit by a car and nobody did anything about it. and excuses are just being made. So what if I just go to the store, and because I'm black and they're mad that their president didn't win, something could happen to me. So that was another thing that I was just really concerned about too. Because it's like, nowhere is really safe. Never, I was never naive to the fact that like, oh my gosh, I can just go and do this, and I'll be fine. Like, no, I've always been the type of person, I've always had my guard up. I've always been very cautious about certain things. But like, I am a human, so there are times where I will lack in life. So that was just like something I was really concerned about. I know my friends and I, we always like talked about like, oh my gosh, should we even like do this? Because I know I had like a couple birthday dinners that I was going to, and we were just kind of concerned like, okay, if we go to this restaurant, will something happen to us? We'll be okay. And it's like, we shouldn't have to have that type of mindset. We shouldn't have to be like, oh my gosh, can I go to the bathroom? You know, it's like stuff like that. We should be able to access the same things that everyone else is accessing. So that was just really crazy as well. But yeah, I think that's all the things that have happened like this year. But now I want to like talk about like myself personally, just kind of get personal with y'all, which is very weird for me because I guess I'm known as being very secretive, but I don't have a problem with that. I know like this year for me was definitely a major wake-up call. I really realized that I need to just take control of my life and turn it around. And I understood like I am the only person that has like the best interest for myself and the Lord Heavenly Father, of course. But I can't expect people to I don't know how I'm supposed to word this. I can't expect people to do things that I would do for them, because we don't all have the same mindset. We don't all have the same outlook in life. So I really just, if I want something, I have to go out there and get it. And that's like, I don't know why I slipped out of that mindset, because that's the way I always moved. Like, I was always like, I'm gonna get everything I deserve and I'm gonna make sure I make it happen. But I think that I got too laid back and too comfortable. I got too comfortable, and I expected certain things from certain people, and it didn't happen. I definitely saw a lot of people for what they were, and it was disheartening, because there are certain people that you look to in life and it's like, I would have never expected this from you. I feel like that's what 2020 was. It was definitely the year of eye opening. It was definitely the year of reality, because you know, 2020 vision, you're seeing things clearly, and that's exactly what we got. I know everyone was like, oh, vision on 2020. It's like, yeah, you got that vision on 2020. So I know that was like really crazy to me. I guess just like going back to like the whole hit by a car thing, when I did finally, if y'all don't really know what I'm talking about, I will like link that stuff up there above. Anything that I bring up, I will put it up there, and y'all can look into it. But the whole hit by a car thing, it was just really surprising to me when I did reveal that this happened, because I didn't tell anyone. I posted on YouTube before I even told anyone verbally that this happened to me. But like, he was going to keep going. He was already on my foot, and like, I'm not a big person, I'm not a curvy person, I'm skinny. So it's like he was halfway to running me over. So it would have took nothing to just finish me off. And it was just, it was just really surprising that was the first thing a lot of people said to me. It was like, why didn't you tell me about this? Or it's like the fact that people often wanted to like force me to talk about it, which I didn't really want to, because I'm still trying to heal over this. I'm still trying to get through this. I'm still trying to get out of the shock of, I'm good with like talking like at a minimum of it, but I'm trying to go into detail. I will summarize, I'll give you the Sparks Notes version of like what it is. So that was another thing too. I know, like, especially with the whole like isolation thing, like I mentioned, I personally do like to be in my room. I find a lot of comfort being by myself than being around people. I am introverted. So with the whole lockdown thing, it's like, even though I like those type of things, even though I like being by myself, I'm fine with like being in my own space, I just couldn't do like the lockdown. Like it was too much for me. And I felt like I was suffocating, even though it's like, oh my gosh, if you don't wear a mask, if you're outside, if you're gonna really be on a ventilator. It's like, yes, I understand that, but it's like I still needed that interaction. I still needed that time with people that I wasn't receiving, and it was like really hard for me. I know that's like around the same time when it was like really getting to that point that it was like really, really difficult for me. That's when I started getting to that point where it was like I started my Zoom and my Z stress. Yeah, my Zoom Z stress talk, and I also linked that up there. And that was like, that was somewhat really helpful because it was nice to like just kind of hear like what's going on with other people, because that's kind of the person I am. I rather hear more about someone else than talk about myself personally. So that was when I started that. Some things that just always have helped me too as well is like I make trillers, and I will insert my triller from my that I did after.
Peace for the night, look. If I call you babe, you babe for the day, or babe for the night, you not my wife. She wanna
shoot, and I also put the vlog up there of my photo shoot. And follow me on Instagram too, that I'll just put right here, and y'all can see like the pictures of the photo shoot as well. But yeah, I do trillers, and that's always just been something I've been doing for like a really long time. Especially when I moved, that was something that really got me through the move, because that was really difficult for me. But with the whole like isolation and everything, trillers were really helpful for me. Another thing that I've always just been really into are like these Instagram page. The way I originally found them was like through Snapchat, but on Instagram it's the Tiny Kitchen, and it's literally what it sounds like. Like, it's someone cooking in a tiny kitchen with tiny ingredients and cooking tiny food. And I don't know if this is the background music or just watching them that I find to be very calming, but that's something that I really like to do. I think another thing too for me is just like watching anime as well has been really helpful. But that was also like something that just really helped me calm myself as well. Anything else that I've done that's really been helpful? But I think a major thing too is like what I learned from like this year is don't let anyone rob you from your happiness. That is something major. I think something that I always did in the past was like go and travel, and I love traveling. But I feel like when it got to those, I don't push myself into these new environments, because it doesn't take away from the fact of like, oh, this is what I'm going through. So I think you definitely don't let anyone rob you from your happiness. Do what is best for yourself. Do what's best for your mental health. I think this is the year that we definitely need to just like kind of take a step back and really reevaluate, like, am I doing, is this what I'm doing, is it making me happy? And is this the right thing? Because you'll know within yourself, like, this is enjoyable to me. This is something that makes sense. So I think that's an overarching thing. Like, just really, with everything that happens with 2020, don't take nothing for granted. You only have one life to live, and you need to live every day, like, not even like it's your last, but it's like with a purpose. Whether it's the smallest thing, going grocery shopping. I like eating food, so I'm gonna go grocery shopping. Just kind of live it with a purpose. Live it with, like, every day should be a great memory. It shouldn't just be like a one thing in your life that's like, oh, I can go back to this day and this is like the only good memory I've had in like weeks, you know? So I think we definitely have to, like, find ways to lift our spirits and just kind of motivate ourselves, because I think that's a major thing. But yeah, I think that's the end of my little mental health check-in. It is currently 2:10 right now, and my screensaver is like a spin off the Powerpuff Girls. That's like my thing. If y'all can see, like, right there, it's like a spin-off of, like, a little remix of Powerpuff Girls. But I think that's the end. I do have work in like 7 hours, I think. Yeah, it's 7 hours, less than 7 hours. So like I said, y'all stay safe, y'all stay motivated, and most definitely keep hair flipping on the haters. I'm literally about to go sleep, so that's why I look like this. I look crazy. And the video that's coming out tomorrow, that one will have like how I looked before. I'll be wearing the same thing, but like I'll look better basically. But yeah, I just wanted to come up on here, just do a mental health check-in. I know this year's been crazy. Let me know some things that you've been doing to just like keep up and like keep your spirits up and everything and keep you motivated. And yeah, it's always good to talk to y'all. So, bye.